Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video where the second chapter of microwave engineering, the microwave linear beam tubes we are with. So here up till now the two cavity klystron working as amplifier, multi cavity klystron also as amplifier, and now the reflex klystron working as oscillator we have seen. The working principles, simple derivations, the parameters to calculate the performance we have seen. We have solved few of the problems based on to the two cavity klystron, multi cavity klystron, reflex klystron also. In the previous video we have gone through the problem number 3 based on to the reflex klystron. Let us have the last problem based on to it. Problem statement for reflex klystron is given as: a reflex klystron operates at the peak mode of n is equal to 2 with V0 is equal to 280 volts, I0 is equal to 22 milliamperes, and signal voltage V1 is equal to 30 volts. Determine input power, output power, and the efficiency. So the problem is very simple. We begin to start for solving input power. So from the given problem statement, we first of all note what is the given data. So here the given data is mode is equal to n is equal to 2. Next to that, we have the DC potential V0 given by 280 volts. I0, the beam current, is given as 22 milliamperes, and the V1 signal is equal to 30 volts. So with these given details, we can use the two op so that the first parameter can be calculated. So for part A, we want the input power. So the input power can be denoted by P suffix DC. Basically, it is of DC type. So it is nothing but the multiplication of the voltage V0 with that of the current for the beam, that is I0. So V0 and I0 both are given to us in our problem statement. V0 is equal to 280 volts, I0 is equal to 22 milliamperes. So here we put the values and make the multiplication. So by the next step, we have 280 in multiplication to 22 into 10 raised to power minus 3 for the milli. So this gives us PDC, that is the input power for the reflex klystron, is equal to 6.16. As it is the power, the SI system of units gives us watts. So I outline this particular value. So this is the answer for part A. Now after determination of input power in part A, we go for calculation of output power. Now for calculation of output power, we denote output power by PAC, because the reflex klystron is working as oscillator. So provided the DC inputs to it, it will produce the oscillating microwave. So for that we have AC type of power. So it is as per the formula we have seen, twice V0 I0 X dash into J1 of X dash divided by 2 pi n minus pi by 2. So we name this equation, let us say this is equation number 1. Now for this equation number 1, if you look onto the RHS, so that time V0, I0 are available in the problem statement that we have utilized in previous portion also. N, number of modes, is also available. X dash and J1 of X dash are unknown. So therefore, for n is equal to 2 provided to us, so the product of X dash with J1 of X dash, it is equal to 1.25 for n is equal to 2. So n is equal to 2 is giving us the maximum output power for these parameters. If you see the graph, you will get 1.25 for this particular product. Now equation number 1 will give us PAC is equal to, we substitute the values here, 2 as it is, V0 it will be 280, then we have I0 is 22 milliamperes, hence 22 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 into the product of x dash with j1 x dash, so that we have to substitute 1.25, so it will be divided by 2 pi into 2 as the first term in the denominator minus pi by 2 as it is. So therefore, by the next step, we can write output power PAC in the simplified form. It will be 15.4 divided by 4 pi minus pi by 2 in the denominator. Therefore, substituting the pi value 3.14, we obtain PAC, the output power for the reflex crystal, is equal to 1.4005 watts. So I outline this answer. So this way, the part B, output power, that also we have computed. Now the last part for the problem number 4 of reflex crystal, that is also the last one, we require to calculate the efficiency. Now as in the previous both portions A and B, we have computed the input power and output power with respect to the reflex crystal, our device. We can simply calculate the efficiency by using the ratio. Therefore, for part C, I denote efficiency by eta and write the simple equation, that is PAC, that is the output power, answer of the part B can be utilized here, divided by PDC, that is the input power, the answer of part A can be utilized here in multiplication to 100, so that efficiency will be in terms of percentage. So here we put 1.4005 in the numerator. In the denominator, 6.16 will be there in multiplication to 100 for this ratio. So finally, the efficiency is obtained as 22.73 53. So it is in terms of percentage. So this was our problem statement for the reflex crystal. We have computed the input power, output power, and the efficiency also. By the next lecture, we shall be starting to learn what exactly the slow wave structures are. The understanding of slow wave structure is very essential so that we can understand the operating of the traveling wave tube, which is another popular tube of the same kind, that is linear beam tube. So I hope you are definitely benefited with the videos we share. For more information on our subject and others, you can definitely subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you.